How long does it feel like you've been waiting for this day?
A long time. You know, it's exciting to be back. The coaching staff was just talking in there about how nice it is to get on the ice and run a practice. The only practices I've run recently are my 11 and 12-year-old sons, and the pace is a little quicker out here. It was nice.
The coaches were tired of talking to each other for 5 months,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah, absolutely.
Were these guys, did they look better than your 11 and 12-year-old sons?
Yeah. They were moving a little quicker, a little crisper. They've come back. They look like they're in great shape. They're excited to be here, and I think excited to get started.
I know you weren't like officially allowed to be around them, but did you take a peek in at the guys skating, and could you tell that they were going to be in decent shape for the first practice?
You know what? I didn't watch them skating much. I obviously saw them coming in and out, and I could tell that they were in good shape. You know, we've got a veteran group and a real professional group, and you know, it really never crossed my mind that there would be any issues with that.
What's the challenge of this week with basically 6 days to get ready for a game?
Well, the challenge is to be prepared to get up to game speed, to get your structure back in place without getting injured. I mean, that's the fine line you walk here with a 5 or 6 day camp.
And you see the coach on the situation in not being here for the first 3 days, but he was playing.
Yeah. You know, Lou addressed it. It's a non-issue for me or the team. Can't wait to get him back here. He's been playing, and I have no issues about his conditioning or anything that he'll miss here in the first 48 hours because he's been, he's ahead of the curve here. He's played 30 plus games.
You see a spot for Dorsch on this team?
You know what? Too early to tell. I'm excited to see him. I've always been a fan, obviously from the other bench, and I haven't had the opportunity to coach him, but it was a nice call when Lou told me he was coming to camp, and I'm excited to see him.
Is it tough starting the season seeing a 9 out there and knowing it's not the other 9?
That's professional sports. Every year you clean the slate and you coach the group you have. I mean, Zach Parise was a great New Jersey Devil, was a great captain here. But we've moved forward, and so has he.
Any ideas who the next captain will be?
We've had some internal discussions, but haven't named one yet.
When might you?
Probably.
Yeah. To monitor their work in practice. I mean, they only have 2 goalies in practice, too.
So. Yeah. Actually, I think we have a real advantage there. In my mind, we have 2, starting goaltenders. And when you're playing 48 games in, 100 days or less, I think the teams that are able to play both goaltenders without worrying about the level falling off from your starter to your backup are at a distinct advantage, and I think we're in that situation here.
Is there a sense of confidence in the sense that you have so many familiar faces back from the team that went to the final that, we can do something this year?
Well, I'll tell you this. I think, when I talk to people about coming out of a lockout, a condensed schedule, 2 of the words that I kept hearing were getting your structure in place quickly and getting up to game speed quickly. Those were the 2 big things that kept consistently coming up. And I think from a structure point of view, the nice thing about having this group is they know our system. They know what we want. The game speed part is something we're going to have to address, but it's definitely nice starting with that foundation as opposed to last year having to implement it all.
What are your feelings on Sikora not coming back? I mean, along with Zach, that's a lot of goals.
Yeah.
Just 2 guys.
Well, I don't play a role in the personnel decisions. Sikora, like Zach, did a great job for us last year. I coach the guys that are here in camp, and there's challenges every camp on trying to you know, fill holes and address weaknesses, and you know, we've got to do that.
You can find those that many goals?
Well, we'll have to.
Have you talked to Marty at all about having already been through a 48-game season and having so much success that he had the last time winning the Cup?
You know, we've got some great experience in that room. Like I said, with an older group, we've got a lot of guys, not only Marty, but Eliash and Salvador, guys who have been in this situation before. And not that anyone's comfortable in this situation, but I think experience is definitely something that I've used in planning out what we're going to do here. And I think, you know, in their comfort level in that dressing room and us being ready.
You've had you coached a team that was willing to go forward instead of just sit back. Without those goals that you've lost, might this be a much more defensive team?
Oh, we're not going to change, you know, our identity or the way we play. That's the best way I can answer that question.
You said you talked to people about what to do to get ready. Was Jacques Lemaire one of the people?
I did talk to Jacques, yeah.
Anybody else, like coaching?
You know what, I talked to a lot of different people. You know, I talked to Paul Maurice, who's a friend of mine, who's over in Russia that went through it. And I talked to Jacques. Obviously, Lou's a great resource. Eliash, Brodeur, Salvador, you know, I mean, over 6 months, you have a lot of conversations with a lot of different people. I'm sure I'm leaving a lot of people off that list, but you know, I think we have a real good plan in place to try and maximize the time we have here and try and get off to a quick start.
No Henry for the start of the season, maybe a couple weeks, hopefully not too long, but how do you deal with that? Do you expect Jacob won't be that? You'll have him by Saturday?
I expect we'll have Joe. You know, here very soon. As far as Henrique out, you know, I think that's going to be something that every team's going to have to deal with this condensed schedule is handling injuries. The nice thing about our team is I believe we showed last year we had interchangeable parts. We could take somebody out, and someone could jump in and take their spot. You know, I'm comfortable that we've got that kind of depth.
Would Eliash have been a center? Either way?
If we're fully healthy, he might not have been, but that's not the case.
Right.
Do you have lines set up, or are you going to have to find out who's going to be?
Yeah, you know what? I mean, you jot some things down on paper, but, you know, injuries play a factor. You know, getting to know some of the new guys play a factor, so nothing concrete.
How much did you watch Albany and Butler kind of got off to a slow start there?
Yeah.
You've really been playing put the puck in the nets really since
the December. As a staff, we watched every Albany game from the start of the season through till just before Christmas, you know, not in person but on tape. So we have a real good handle on that group. And, you know, the guys here at camp are the guys I think that deserve to be here based on that.
Is Butler where he was skating today with Travis? Is that a real possibility or?
You know what, we're putting Cam together. It's too early to say. Still got a pretty good right winger we're waiting on.
Oh, is he still a right winger?
Yes.
Still a right winger?